You're going to see now two tables which really complement each other. And to understand the whole story, definitely you need both of them, as you will see them just now. Quite difficult, maybe, for those who don't know English, but I will try to explain as much as I can, because it's very, very important to understand the idea of codes. Of course, you cannot work one code here, one code. In fact, the all codes are connected. Means that sometimes something is missing in one code, you find it in another one. It is so important because it is all teaching, it is all doctrine. Really, now you are busy doing a book, Doctrine of Messiah, because it is a full learning. You cannot look in one table only, you have to see few of them. Now you will have example, you will have two significant tables, no doubt, but you will see clearly how one really complements the other one. Now what you have here, this is really, there is a site which is called Kil Hashem Amlucha, the kingdom is to God, and this was the bring here. The first they bring very interesting, Gematria, Biat HaMashiach, the coming of Messiah, comes in Gematria 776. Tavshinayin Vav, which is unfortunately Ben Zur already hit, it was 3 years ago, from the time of the creation of man, 2 years ago. Now, interesting, as I many times brought the principle of Messiah, of the Gematria, there are a lot, I wrote a book with more than 200 years about length of Gematria. And one of the ways of Gematria, when you take the verse and the kolel, the general number, so it will come to 778 with the two verses, with the 779 with the additional. So whatever it is, yeah, we are in a very important time here. So what they found, Kil Hashem Amlucha, they found here Tavshin Ayin Vav 576 Ibane will be built. What we will build? Mikdash, the temple. I tracing, they point out that it will come in very suitable place. It is when the Torah says that the Jewish people were solely Mikdash, do a temple for me, v'shachanti b'tocham, and then I will dwell within them, right? And Lashem, this is really the purpose, to build a temple to God. So we saw already that really in the building will be partnership between God and the Jewish people. Now, so this is, and also they found it, by the way, the son of Jesse, Ben Ishai, you should build. So whatever it is interesting. But it is not so interesting that it did not come. You want it very much. So what happened? Why? So there is another table which I found, which really explained why we did not have the temple in Messiah yet. And this is a table. So what I found here? I found here Ibane Mikdash, yeah? Straight, Ibane Mikdash. Temple will be built only once in the Torah, by the way, yeah? Ibane Mikdash. And I looked for meetings with 5776, which was, this was the right time, but something was missing. So comes here also Ibane Mikdash, temple will be built. You can see in red Ibane Mikdash, it's a very small skip of 5776, right? Even you have next week Yavoh Eliyahu, that Elijah will come. Yeah? But, no. What more it is in this table? You have Meshichim. Minimum the Torah. Meshichim, Messiahs, and who is Messiahs? And you know, rabbis tell us that the letters of the word Mashiach, Mem, Shin Yud Chet, indicate the name of the Messiahs, which is Menachem, Shiloh, Inon, Hananiah. Definitely the idea is that not four with different names. The idea is, because each name has meaning, like Menachem, he will comfort us. Inon, will be like a king, kingdom. Hananiah, also the grace. And Shiloh, 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 yeah, Shiloh. Very known, it is Shiloh, it means present to him, the word give present to him. You see his greatness. So, amazingly, so he written, me Meshichim, who are the Messiahs? And so he's written there, Inon, Shiloh, Menachem, then, no, what, where is the Messiah? Where is the temple? So comes here the answer. Minimal in the Old Torah, ha-teshuva, the repentance. Minimal in the Torah, ha-teshuva. And it comes exactly in the story, uparo ikriv, Pharaoh came near, I saw Israel at the name, and the Jewish people, children of Israel, lifted up his eyes. By the way, here is a story that Pharaoh and all his chariots, and all his soldiers, chased the Jews on the way to the Red Sea. And, you know, Jews saw the Egyptian after them, the sea in front, didn't know what to do. So, what they did, had Shuvah, they did not Shuvah, a real good repentance. And also in Hebrew is written Ikriv and not Karav. Ikriv means that Pharaoh brought their heart near to God. Amazing. So, Atshuva. So here is the answer. You ask, we are in the year of Biat HaMashiach, the Messiah. Why did that come? So many times people ask, but they don't see my tablets properly. It's almost every place you have the Tshuva. And this is what Maimonides says. The Rambam says, Israel will not be saved only by repentance, but the Torah, God promised, they will do tshuva in them. It can be the result of such situation, you know, like was in Egypt, the threat of Iran and so on. Don't forget that these people have thousands of missiles which can reach each point in Israel. And this iron, cannot tell it much. But what more we have here? We have here, very, very interesting. You have the place Moriah. This is the place. You see Moriah comes here. Yeah? You have the son of Jesse again. Then we have also salvation, Shua. We need very much salvation. And very, very important, also redemption, by the way, Geula also. But, no, we missed 5776. No, what is the other time? So if you followed my YouTubes, I told you, what Rabbi Berland said, there's a process of redemption up to the end of days. It will be from 576, it will carry on after, up till 5781. Yeah, 5781. And this is what you have here, from 5781, right? This is exactly the time. 581. So, it means we have 2 years. Yeah, we are now sitting at 7, but this is 581, right? So, this what is written here, that Beita in Hebrew is in the time when it really will come, as we said, there is a time, a fixed time, Beita, and this is from, means the process will start me from 581. So interesting and important and significant. We have also the Hebrew word, Amishkan. This is the test of testimony, which was in the desert, right? Not the temple. So as we said, very, very interesting, significant table. As in table, you have Ibane Mikdash, 577-6. Elijah will come, you know, Elijah will come with Messiah. Even many, you have two Meshichim. You have the son of Joseph, the first one who prepares the way, get rid from the enemies of Israel, and then son of David will come, son of Jesse, which comes here also. So all this, what you have in this table is unbelievable, because it is clearly answer the question. Yeah, we saw such a beautiful table, Kil Hashem Amlucha, so beautiful coming, the right location, no, in the ear. What happened? So what happened? You see, what is Shuva? So as I said, very important teaching behind this YouTube that you are going to see, follow it properly, because this explains what is really Torah called. It's the old doctrine. This was said, it's not only you see one table here, you have to understand properly things. You must look at it in some tables which have the same subject and to understand, because it is like learning, you know, like learning Yeshiva Talmud. You know, you have to learn one verse here, one verse, other verse explains it. The same thing with Torah codes. It's all teaching, all learning, and Now I work on a book which is called The Doctrine of Messiah, and then you will see really how to learn codes. It's all learning, all studying. It's not a matter of looking one table here. It's already you come to conclusion. No, I will not come to a conclusion. I will not, if you will not look in the whole picture. The important, significant table.